Good morning students, today we are going to discuss about module number 1, that is introduction to power system, overhead transmission lines and overhead line insulators. So here we are going to discuss a concept called a brief introduction to types of supporting structures and line conductors. So a brief introduction to types of supporting structures and line conductors, that is an overhead line comprises mainly of conductors, supports, insulators and pole fittings. Then the function of overhead line is to transmit electrical energy, and the important characteristics which the line conductors must have, that means the overhead line conductors have the following characteristics. One is called it possesses high electrical conductivity. Conductivity means at what amount of the force it allows the flow of electrons through the conductor is called as electrical conductivity. Simply it is reciprocal of resistivity. Then the overhead line conductors offers that high tensile strength, that means good mechanical strength, and low density, and also for low cost. Next, in general, in order to make the conductors, the following are the metals what we are use, like we use copper, aluminium and steel. These are used either alone or in combination, that means alloy. There are various types of conductors which are used in the transmission system, but each and every type of conductor it is going to manufacture from the following materials like copper, aluminium, steel cored aluminium, galvanized steel and cadmium copper. Next, first of all we are going to discuss about the properties of each and every material, because these are the following materials which are using in order to manufacture that or in order to design the conductors as to transfer the electricity from one end to another end. So first of all here we look about that copper. Normally hard drawn copper is used as 2 times stronger than soft drawn copper, because hard drawn copper is nothing but the copper where it is heated up to like 250 degrees centigrade and suddenly dip into water, hence become as a hard drawn copper. Soft drawn copper is nothing but the copper which is heated up to 250 degrees centigrade and it is exposed to atmosphere. According to the atmosphere temperature it will cool down, hence it become as soft drawn copper. So when you compare that hard drawn copper and soft drawn copper, hard drawn copper is used as 2 times stronger than soft drawn copper because it has high mechanical strength and it is best in conductivity, because as we know that about the copper it is a good conductor, and it has higher current density because it can transfer that high amount of current through the copper. Then for a given current rating level, lesser cross section area of conductor required. It provides lesser cross section area to wind loads. That means this copper material having the capability even for lesser cross section area, it is going to bear that wind gusts or heavy winds, and the copper has low specific resistance. That means we know the formula capital R is equal to rho L by A. The value of rho is very very low for copper, and it is durable and has higher scrub value. It is durable means it has that higher reliability and durability, and it has higher scrub value because it is going to suspended by any rear and tear while we are wounding the wire, while we are giving the connections. If it is subjected to any stress, some mechanical stress, it can withstand. So that is that one of the good nature or good property in case of copper. Next we are going to discuss about that aluminium. It is cheaper and it is light as compared to copper, because whose density is small, that's what, and the cost is also cheaper compared to copper, and it has a smaller conductivity when compared with copper. The conductivity is smaller, and the conductivity of an hard drawn aluminium is around 60% of the copper. When you compare that hard drawn aluminium similar to that hard drawn copper, there is a hard drawn aluminium. How hard drawn aluminium is going to manufacture? Because it is heated up to maximum heat like 250 degrees centigrade, then suddenly it is dipped into water and become as hard drawn aluminium. Then hard drawn aluminium has the capability to transfer that electricity up to that 60% of that copper. For same ohmic resistance, when you compare that the same rho value of aluminium and copper, if you compare, its diameter is 1.2 times that of copper. That means aluminium diameter is 1.27 times it is greater when you compare with copper. Due to this increased cross section of aluminium, it exposes more to wind pressure. So due to the presence of this increased cross section area of a given aluminium conductor, it has the withstand capability to bear that heavy wind pressure or heavy wind gusts. Next, the supporting tower should be designed for higher traverse length, because if you are going to make that supporting towers, that means transmission poles which are going to design, it has that higher traverse length. That means wherever we are place these towers, that means aluminium towers which are crossing the roads, there due to the construction of these high height of supporting towers, we can get that higher traverse length, where people, more amount of people will pass on through the conductor or through the tower. Higher tower leads greater sag of conductors, because whenever that distance or height of the towers, if it is high, it leads to greater sag. Sag is nothing but there is a sag between the two successive poles because of the extradiction and contradiction. Due to that variation in the climate, the successive poles, actually there is a span of length L, but due to this huge heat of the temperature, the length of the successive poles of the conductor has been increases due to the extradiction, hence it is called as a sag. So higher tower leads that greater sag of conductors, and the supporting structures for aluminium need not to be made as strong as the design for copper, because copper tensile strength is less compared to the tensile strength of aluminium. So that's why supporting structures the supporting structures, that means transmission poles, are going to manufacture with aluminium and its combination, not for the copper, because copper tensile strength is lower compared to aluminium. Compared to copper, aluminium has advantages and it is widely used because of its high tensile strength or mechanical strength. Next, steel. Though it has a greater tensile strength because of its higher resistance, it is least used because it has that good attractive feature, that is high tensile strength, that is a good mechanical strength is there, but whose resistance is very high per unit centimeter compared to aluminium and copper. So that's why it is not used in case of an conductor in much ratio. Only for lower ratio we can choose this steel while we are going to manufacture the conductors. Due to rusting, steel wires are not used, but galvanized steel wires are used. Because of the presence of rusting, if you are going to use the normal steel wires, the conductor may get rust and it may get damaged. So instead of using the normal steel wires, we are using the galvanized steel, which protects from rusting. Then if you look at the properties of steel, it has the following properties, that is, it is lowest in conductivity compared to aluminium and copper, and it has higher internal reactance. Due to that higher internal reactance, it has that higher tensile strength and mechanical strength. It is much subjected to eddy current loss and hysteresis loss because it is a steel. That's why there are unwanted currents are placed on the conductor if you are going to use this steel. Hence the currents are not moving from one end to another end, thereby it is circulating, hence it is called as eddy current loss. And due to the presence of that alternating current having the frequency, there exists that a loss called hysteresis loss. These two losses are called as core losses because of the steel core. Then it is not preferred in a damp atmosphere because it is rejected. Damp atmosphere means where suddenly the climate has been changes from rainy to then windy, and windy to then summer and like hot. In those cases, this material is not preferred, because if it is preferred in those cases, that is in case of a damp atmosphere, due to this damp atmosphere there exist that losses, that's what its use is limited in any proportion in any alloy while we are using that steel in terms of mixture. Thank you.